Which one of Samsung's Galaxy Note tablets are the best? I'm Taylor Martin, this is Pocket Now, and this is the Galaxy Note 10.1 2014 edition versus the Galaxy Note 8.0. Samsung's Galaxy Note series is particularly unique in that it offers an incredible amount of productivity-driven features, as well as hardware which caters to that sort of use case. This time, we're taking a look at two of Samsung's latest Galaxy Note tablets, the Note 8.0 and Note 10.1 2014 edition. Which is the better tablet? Is the Note 8.0's compact nature enough to offset the extra power of the Note 10.1? Let's find out. On the outside, these two tablets are a lot alike, yet at the same time, they're distinctly different. The Galaxy Note 8.0 is obviously much smaller. It measures 210.8mm tall, 135.9mm wide, and only 8mm thick. The Note 10.1, on the other hand, is 243.1mm tall, 171.4mm wide, and 7.9mm thick. As a result, the Note 10.1 is also significantly heavier at 540 grams. The Note 8.0 is a staggering 202 grams lighter. Although both tablets require two hands for use, the Note 8.0 is also much easier to hold with one hand and use with the other, while the Note 10.1 will often be held with two hands and used with thumbs. Between February, when the Note 8.0 was announced, and September, Samsung adopted a slightly refreshed design with new materials, or at least a new finish. Like the Galaxy S4, the Note 8.0 offers wide radius corners, rounded edges, and a hyperglaze finish around back. The Note 10.1 is more likened to the Galaxy Note 3, with its hard edges and aligned faux metal trim, mortifying corners, and a faux leather backing. In this short time period, Samsung also took the opportunity to upgrade specifications across the board. Internally, these two tablets have almost nothing in common. The Note 8.0 comes with an Exynos 4412 chipset, powered by a 1.6 GHz quad-core CPU. It has 16 or 32 GB of storage with a microSD card slot, 2 GB of RAM, a 5-megapixel rear camera, and a 4600 mAh 17 watt-hour battery. The Note 10.1 2014 edition comes with the Exynos Octa chip, or two quad-core CPUs, one clocked at 1.9 GHz and the other at 1.3. It has 16, 32, or 64 GB of storage with a microSD card slot, 3 GB of RAM, an 8-megapixel camera, and a 31 watt-hour battery with a capacity rating of 8220 mAh. Both come with Bluetooth 4.0 and infrared, but the Note 10.1 comes with Wi-Fi AC, and neither tablet has NFC on board. The biggest hardware difference, however, is their displays. Of course, they differ in size, 2.1 diagonal inches to be exact, but we're talking purely about the quality of their respective panels. The Note 8.0 has an 8-inch display at a resolution of 1280 by 800 pixels. That's only 189 pixels per inch. The TFT panel offers decent color reproduction, very wide viewing angles, deep blacks, passable contrast, and it's quite bright. But pixelation is noticeable even from a comfortable viewing distance. This is not a problem we've had with the 10.1-inch 2560 by 1600 pixel resolution display on the larger Note. Its super clear LCD display offers fantastic colors, viewing angles, contrast, deep blacks, and it's incredibly bright. We'd wager that it's one of the best displays we've ever held, period. And in the same trend of the Note 10.1 superiority trickles down to even the finer points of the hardware, the S Pen. The Note 8.0 uses the older S Pen with a hard plastic tip. Its butt is carved to the shape of the corner of the tablet, which means it's hidden and integrated more seamlessly, but the Note 10.1's location is more natural for unsheathing the S Pen, and it's easier to locate without feeling around for it. Its S Pen can be inserted in two different orientations, and its tip is made of rubber, which causes some friction. This takes some getting used to, but after you spend some time with it, you learn to like it even more, as it helps with control and stability of use. Think of it as writing with a felt tip on paper instead of a ballpoint on ice. In virtually every hardware category, the Note 10.1 is superior to its older cousin, not just because it features better specifications across the board, but because it has been designed with more care. Samsung has tirelessly refined the Galaxy Note brand, and it shows. The Note 10.1 feels executive and premium, whereas the Note 8.0 still feels somewhat like a toy to us. The software side of things is still in favor of the newer, larger, more powerful tablet, but much less so than in hardware. The Galaxy Note 8.0 originally shipped with Android 4.1.2, missing some of the best features of Jelly Bean, such as lock screen widgets, daydream mode, and a dedicated page within the notification shade for toggles. Fortunately, the Note 8.0 has received Android 4.2, with all these useful features in tow. The Note 10.1, however, comes with Android 4.3. The differences between what the stock Android versions of these firmwares come with are pretty slim, especially to the naked eye. you get trim and OpenGL ES 3.0 support in 4.3, as well as multiple user support with restricted profiles, Bluetooth Smart Ready support, and additional Project Butter enhancements. Multi-user support is effectively killed by the TouchWiz skin, and some may argue that Project Butter performance improvements are counterbalanced by how heavily laden TouchWiz is. It's fair to say, though, that the biggest differences between the software versions of these two tablets are found within Samsung's own software anyway. Both notes come with the most notable TouchWiz features and bloat: Smart Stay, S Note, Group Play, Samsung Apps, Samsung Hub, S Voice, Watch On, etc. But there is what some might consider fragmentation from within Samsung's own ecosystem. The S Pen optimizations are far less prevalent on the Note 8.0. Holding the S Pen button and long pressing on the display will take a screenshot on either tablet, but holding the button and double tapping the display will open S Note on the Note 8.0, but it will open Action Memo on the Note 10.1. Removing the S Pen from its slot opens the far more useful and accessible Air Command pop-up. Both tablets also come with a multi-window feature, but the Note 10.1 has some optimizations beyond those of the 8.0. You can create preset pairs of applications to open within multi-window, and you can also drag and drop content between applications. You can't do either of these things on the Note 8.0. These may only be small discrepancies, but they make a lasting impression, especially after you get used to using the newer features. Hopefully these enhancements will find their way to the Note 8.0 before long, but for now the Note 10.1 takes the cake. Performance, surprisingly enough, is not so much in favor of the Note 10.1, at least not in day-to-day tasks. Opening applications, switching apps, and even using a multi-window, the Note 8.0 is a half beat snappier than the Note 10.1. Pressing the home button brings you out of the app and back to your home screen faster. Even loading apps is quicker, and so is opening the application drawer. The difference is negligible in most cases, though. If you used both devices apart from one another, you'd probably never tell. But something we haven't been troubled with on the Note 8.0 is intermittent freezing. The Note 10.1 has a problem with hanging mid-load more than we'd care to admit. This is an issue Michael had with the International Galaxy Note 3, also powered by the Exynos Octa. The Octa scores quite well in benchmarks, and it's able to maintain higher frame rates during gaming. For multimedia and entertainment purposes, the Note 10.1 is fantastic, but it struggles with the simple things. We credit the Note 8.0's snappiness to the difference in pixels. It's pushing only 1/4 of the number of pixels the Note 10.1 is pushing. Something else worth noting, since the 10.1 has an additional gigabyte of RAM, it is capable of keeping more in memory for a longer period of time. The Note 8.0 has to load some recent apps from scratch. The speaker performance on the 10.1 is markedly better, as the Note 8.0's bottom edge speakers are incredibly easy to cover up entirely. They're more tinny, not as loud, and just don't do a multimedia tablet any justice. By no means are the Note 10.1 speakers terribly impressive, particularly when you compare them to the Nexus 10. Battery performance isn't bad on either tablet, to be honest. The 17 watt-hour battery inside the Note 8.0 managed to last us about a day and a half to 2 days on a single charge, and standby was tolerable during our review period. Though in much heavier usage, you could probably manage to kill the Note 8.0 in a single day. The 31 watt-hour battery inside the Note 10.1 is noticeably better in use, but its standby leaves room for improvement. We're still testing the battery on the Note 10.1, however, so look for more detailed information in the full review. The camera on the Note 8 is, well, there. It takes pictures, but don't count on its quality. The 5-megapixel image sensor is outpaced by most smartphones on the market from the last 2 years. Images lack sufficient color reproduction, detail, and contrast. They're dull and full of noise in just about any lighting conditions. The Note 10.1 is markedly better at picture taking, but it's not terribly impressive either. Outdoors and bright lighting conditions provide decent, vibrant pictures. Anything else results in bland, noisy images with lots of artifacts. Of these two Samsung Galaxy Notes, it's pretty clear which is the better tablet all around. And it's easy to imagine how differently this sort of comparison would go if we were comparing the Note 10.1 to an updated Note 8, or if the 10.1 were powered by a Snapdragon 800 instead of the troublesome Exynos Octa. But that isn't the case. So which is it? The form factor and more steady performance of the Note 8.0, or the gorgeous display and better multimedia experience on the Note 10.1? For us, as much as we hate lag and stutters, the display is a make-or-break feature in a tablet, and the Note 8.0 isn't up to the challenge. Plus, the additional S Pen features and build quality of the Note 10.1 seals the deal for us. That said, we like the form factor of the Note 8.0 better, and we can't wait to see what the refresh of the Note 8.0 will be like once it arrives. That's all for now. If you enjoyed the video, let us know by clicking the thumbs up button below and subscribe to the channel to see more videos in the future. Videos like this one and different types of videos from different Pocket Now editors. You can find us on Twitter, Facebook, and Google Plus at Pocket Now. You can find me on Twitter at Casper Tech. I'm Taylor Martin, and I will see you next time.